Welcome to our two-step verification training. Today, what we're going to see is a quick overview, how to enroll, register, authenticate, and manage your devices. So my name is Anoush, and today we are featuring a special guest speaker, our Information Security Officer, Cheryl Aquino, as well as Director of IT Security and Compliance. And without further ado, Cheryl, you may take the stage.
Good morning, everybody. So the reason why we're doing two-step verification and we've offered this as an option for several years now, the CSU is moving a step further with trying to get all of the campuses to implement the required two-step verification, or what they call MFA, for all logins. The reason why this is being done is because it's a better way of securing your access. Kind of like the banking industry, what they're doing is they're using MFA for their access. We've got Google and Yahoo to also do some form of two-step verification. So it just makes sure that we've identified, or at least in the security industry, that passwords are not secure. And I believe that a lot of people realize that passwords are not always secure because, people choose insecure passwords like 123 or hello, or, this is just a way that when you use your password, it's one verification. And when you use a second device, and what we're doing here is the two-step verification that verifies you are who you are, as a second means of authentication. All right, so, and then when you're just, I just wanted to make sure that when you're doing your installation of the application on your mobile device, make sure that you're looking for dual mobile, which on the App Store, because there are other apps called Duo, but they're not the same. So you wanna look for that green image, the logo, that says dual mobile. I guess I can turn it back over to Anoush.
Thank you, Cheryl. Let's go ahead and see how Duo works along with our portal login. So I'm going to quickly play this video. It's a short video. It shows you how easy it is to use the push notifications. So some of the compatible devices that I'm sure you already know about are mobile phones and tablets, landlines, hardware tokens. Now, hardware tokens are available by request, and we ask you to have your hardware token before you go to enroll in two-step, and that also includes signing up on the web page. And the reason for this is just so that you don't run into any issues trying to log into your account after having signed up already. So next, this is a quick overview of how the sign up works. You click sign me up. Now it's showing you where you're going to log in. And it's the same account as your portal username and password. Then on the next page, you're going to click confirm. And once you click confirm, what happens is within 24 hours, just like the screen says right after that, you're going to get an enrollment email from Duo Security. And it may take up to 24 hours, but if you don't see it because it might've gotten buried in your inbox, just make sure to do a keyword search. Once you sign up, and let's say you try to go to the portal and try to log in, you're going to see Duo. So that's why you want to make sure to have your device with you, whether that's the hardware token, whether that's your mobile phone, which is, by the way, the easiest way and the quickest way to log into the portal once you have Duo set up. So this is what you're going to see on the screen whenever you sign up. And before you finish your enrollment, this is what the email looks like. As you can see, we've highlighted the subject line, which says CalStudyLA two-step verification enrollment. And within this email, you're going to have an activation link. So once you click that activation link, what you're going to be able to do is finish setting up your device, whether that is your smartphone or a regular phone, which you just want to use the texting passcodes on, the SMS passcodes, or your hardware token. So you can have your Duo mobile app ready on your device and then click the activation link so that when you get to the screen that says, do you have Duo mobile, you'll say, I have it right away, instead of, you know, waiting until it downloads and running into any other issues like that. From there, you would just follow the on-screen instructions. Okay, so what I'm going to do actually is switch over to the portal and show you live. I have this account ready to go. As you saw in a couple of slides ago, the account signed up and it's already activated. So now what we're going to do is we're going to try logging in. Alrighty. So keep in mind, this account that I used had already signed up on our two-step verification page. Now, once you sign up and you head over to the portal to log in, this is what you're going to see. So now I'm going to go ahead and go through the setup process. So you click Start Setup. And I'm going to go ahead and register a tablet now. Click Continue. And my tablet is Android, so I'm going to choose Android. Continue again. And so this screen allows you some time to look for Duo Mobile, and the step instructions are there. Once you install it and have it ready, you can pull up your application, and then you can say, I have Duo Mobile installed. On the next screen, it's going to give you a QR code. Now I'm going to use this QR code to scan, and I just scanned. The application interface, which you will see in the next screen, has the ability to add more accounts. So once you know it's successfully added, you're going to see a green check mark on the QR code. And then click Continue. And if you notice, actually, you have other choices. If you aren't able to use the QR code, you can click the Email Me activation link instead too. Now on this account, I only have one device, but if I had more, they would all be listed on the screen here. I would see Android, I would see a phone here, I would see other things. Let's say if I have an iOS iPad, that would be listed here as well. And eventually, if you have a lot of devices as backup, you would have to scroll in here so you could see the rest of these buttons. But this is your settings and devices. You can add another Android device here if you would like. You can choose your options here if you want to change the device name so that you can clearly identify which is which. You might have multiple Android devices. So let's say if I want this to be the tablet, I'm going to name it tablet. You can save it there. And you can choose an authentication method. Because this is a tablet, you really only have one choice. You can't really get text on this. So I'm going to go with automatically send this device a Duo push. So this means it's going to cut the time with you choosing the method. And I'll show you how that works too. And you can click save just to make sure your settings are saved. And when you're ready to log in, you click back to login. Now it's actually sending me a Duo push. This is the demo of how it works. It's requesting that I approve, and I'm going to approve because this is me logging in. And now I'm in. So I'm going to go back to our slides here. The completing device registration, you didn't quite see how it was on my end. So I'm going to quickly play you a video that we found from Duo that will show you what it looks like, essentially.
Getting started with Duo Security. You should receive notification on how to get set up. Follow the simple on-screen instructions on how to add your mobile device for authentication. Download the Duo Mobile app from the App Store. scan the QR code on the screen with Duo Mobile. Next time you log in to your account, clicking Send Me a Push will send a notification to your mobile phone. Just hit Approve and you are securely logged in.
Alrighty, now you saw how quickly you can log in with Duo. This is what the screen looks like whenever you have different options. Let's say if you added your phone, whether that's iOS or Android, and you have the ability to call your phone, you have the ability to enter a passcode that they text to you, or you could just use the push. Back in the settings and devices, you can actually choose to automatically be sent a push notification. So you can bypass this step if you would like. And that's what I did when I chose automatically send me a push. But you can leave that out and, you know, choose how you want to authenticate yourself. So you would only approve, by the way, if it's you logging in. When you, let's say, get timed out, you actually see a timeout screen on the Duo end. So if you successfully log in, you'll see a green bar come up at the bottom of your Duo Mobile, the little module there. But if you're timed out, this is what it'll look like. Now the push notification looks just as you see in the screenshot here. It has a big button to approve and it has another button to deny. You only want to approve when you are the one logging in. And this is how we make sure that your account is going to stay secure. Now, let's say if you are working on something else, you are not anywhere close to the portal or any of the applications that are going to have Duo Mobile on them, you're not logging in, and all of a sudden you get some kind of push notification that says, allow to log in. Well, you're not logging in right now. So in that case, you would click deny, and it's going to ask you why you're denying. If you're not logging in, then what you want to select is fraudulent. So it gives you the option for fraudulent so that then it automatically alerts our IT to investigate where this is coming from. So just keep that in mind. In the case that, let's say, you didn't want to send a push notification for whatever reason and you deny it, you also have the option to click that it was a mistake. So keep those two in mind, and they're pretty self-explanatory, so use them as you would. So here's more information about the hardware token. There are different types of hardware tokens that you may come across. And as I mentioned before, make sure that you put in a request for sure. If you don't want to use your push notification, which again, it's the easiest way and the quickest, most efficient way. If you don't want to use the push notification and not your phone at all, then make sure to put in the request for a hardware token before you sign up on our two-step page. And that is to allow seamless access to your account. Otherwise, if you sign up, the screen to start setting up your Duo Mobile will come up. And if you don't have your hardware token at hand, then that would cause issues, which of course you can always contact our help desk to help you, but we just want to, you know, be proactive. So you have the ability to request a token, and that is also found on our two-step page on the link that you see on the screen. Just make sure to have the name, email, your affiliation, staff, faculty, or student, and contact information. We can have this mailed out to you if you wish, or you can pick it up in person.
Hi, Anush. I wanted to clarify that.
Yes.
So this is prior to the cutover date. If you're enrolling early, prior to the faculty staff cutover date and the student cutover date, then you can request. I mean, you can do the early enrollment, but after that date, on that cutover date, it's gonna be stuck at that setup screen. So that's why we're requesting people sign up early.
Yeah, so just make sure to, you know, do all this early before the cutover date, which is March 10. And we will see that later on as well. I have a reminder, but just make sure to keep that in mind. Do it now. Don't wait. It's really easy. Once you set it up, it's done. After that, all you have to do is just authenticate. So moving on, some of the passcodes, the way they work is you can either have it texted to your phone, or if you have the hardware token, that number that comes up, that's what you would input where it says passcode. So once you select passcode, it'll allow you to enter the number right in the field that's highlighted. If you need new codes, if you're using the hardware token, you could just refresh using the button on the hardware token. But if you're using a text to phone, then you can select text me new codes right from the Duo Mobile module, which you see on the screen. Once you input the code, you click login and it will successfully log you in, no questions asked. If by any chance the code that you entered doesn't work because you had used it before, if you're using the text to phone, then it kind of hints to you which one you should use next. Here it says, oh, it starts with a one. So if for any reason, let's say you got a new phone, make sure the first thing you do before you try to, you know, authenticate or log in or anything is add your new phone to your Duo. When you add a new phone, and I'm going to switch back to my little application here. Okay, I'm going to head over to the portal again just to show you. So it's asking me to authenticate because it wants me to log in, but I wanted to show you this live because it might, you might miss it. It's really easy to miss and I've done it before. So you might actually authenticate before you get a chance to add your new device. Remember, if you want to add a new device, you got a new phone or you know, just want to add a backup that you didn't have before, you got a tablet, please do so, but don't authenticate yet. First, when you log into the portal, you have to click add a new device, or if you want to just manage your settings and devices, you can click that. But I'm gonna go to my settings and devices because I don't have another phone right now with me. It's gonna look the same, but pretty much the request is to authenticate that it's you. All right, I authenticated. So even though the screen looked the same, on the back end, it did something different. As soon as I clicked my settings and devices, it knows to take you to the settings and devices and not the portal. So that's why if you ever want to add a device, you still have to go to the portal. You still have to type in your username and password. But before you actually approve your own login, just remember to click add a new device. And then it'll take you to that setup screen where you choose what kind of device it is. And then you would enter your phone number again and so on and so forth. Then when you get to this screen at the very end of that setup process, what you can do is you can actually choose to remove any of your other devices. I don't see it here because it's the only device I have. If I had multiple devices, then one of them would have removed device. So that's what I wanted to show you. And when you're done setting them up, you would make sure to click save and then back to login. And it would authenticate again. It wants to triple check that it's you. I approved it and now I'm in. So we don't have too much information because really it's really easy to use. The setup process, the authentication process, managing your devices, everything I showed you, that's all there is to it. But we do have some security tips for you to keep in mind. It's always a good idea to have an additional device as backup. Make sure you delete your old devices because if you don't remove your account from the Duo Mobile app, then what it's going to do is it's going to send a push to that and you might get confused as to which one you need to approve with. So just remember, as soon as you get a new device and you want to remove the old device, head to the portal just as we saw and do the whole manage my devices thing and then get to the end screen and delete it. Of course, if you run into any issues at all, you can contact the help desk as well as if you suspect any fraudulent activity. And this is really important because it kickstarts our investigation process. So here are some key reminders for faculty and student employees. You would have to enroll before March 10 again, so that you don't get stuck at that screen and end up having to wait any kind of long, you know, queues if you're trying to contact our help desk, which they do an amazing job all the time. But please, I can't stress enough, do it today. Enroll in Duo today. And if you have any colleagues that you talk to for work, we all do virtually, of course, please encourage them to remind your colleagues to enroll and set up their Duo before March 10. It's going to be easy to miss. And for students, just remember that the cutoff date is March 24. So for them, we want them to enroll before March 24. The only other information I leave you with is our contact information. So you know how to reach us at the help desk. We are also available via ServiceNow tickets. And if you have any questions, please type them into the chat and we will get to them. Thank you.
Anish, we do have some questions.
So the first question that we got was, I'm going to buy a cell phone. Anything special about the phone? Cheryl, would you like to jump in on this one?
It just needs to be a smartphone that you can install the Duo mobile application on.
Right. So thank you for that question. It can be iOS or Android, and you really just need to have access to the App Store, which you would from both of those systems, and just install the Duo mobile app. And other questions? The other question is, what happens when you get a new phone? When you get a new phone, as I mentioned, you want to make sure to add it. But if there's a case where you, let's say, lost your phone, then I believe our escalation process is to contact the help desk. And you can correct me if I'm wrong, Cheryl.
Yeah, that's fine.
Great. But just remember, you can take care of it yourself. Once you get a new phone, add that device right away. Add that device and remove your old one. All right, another question we have is, should we get a token in case our cell phone does not work or gets lost? You can have a token, but you can also have a backup phone.
So we're encouraging people to register multiple devices, just like Mr. Hunt suggested. You don't have to use a token. So you can use a tablet if you have a tablet. And like Anish said, if you have another a different phone, you can have that phone number registered. You can register multiple phone numbers as a backup. But yes, tokens are available. On a limited supply.
Thank you, Cheryl. All right, another question that we have is, do we need to do this for using Zoom or Canvas whenever we log into them each time? Is Duo, Cheryl, going to be on Zoom and Canvas?
So Zoom and Canvas, well, not on Zoom, because you don't have to log into the portal in order to get to Zoom. But if you log into the portal to get to Zoom or Canvas, then of course you're going to be challenged at the portal. We're not setting it up for direct connection. We don't have those set up. So it's not right now.
Can I ask a question?
Sure. Yes, please.
Yes, thank you. So, if we are just going to Zoom to start a class or hold a consultation with a student, we do not have to go through this dual verification process, correct?
So the clarification lies in how you access Zoom. If you are using the desktop application, and it's installed on your, let's say, laptop, if you're using that desktop application and you schedule all your meetings using the desktop application and you don't always go through the portal, then you're not going to see any screen that asks you to, make sure to authenticate. But if you do use the portal to log into Zoom as one of the quick launches, then you will see Duo.
Okay. In my case, I have my Zoom already saved, you know, as a Google Chrome item. So I don't really go to the portal. I just click it. It's like a favorite. So I don't have to go to the portal, correct?
It sounds like you wouldn't have to, no. But even if you do, as you saw, the Duo mobile app or any other way that you authenticate, it's really easy. So no worries about that.
Okay, thank you.
What about
Canvas? I also don't go to the portal. I have Canvas, you know, saved just like Zoom is saved as one of my favorites under Google Chrome. I also don't have to go to the portal. So I don't need to do the dual verification process.
Cheryl, would you be able to clarify that if they log in directly to Canvas?
Yeah, I'm not a Canvas user, but if it directs you back to the portal to do authentication, then it will challenge you. If it doesn't direct you to the portal, then it won't challenge you. It won't do the two-step verification.
I see.
And with regards to the Zoom question, you know, and I since, you know, of course we are all Zoom users, when I do a Zoom session, I'm enrolled in two-step verification. I've been using it for quite a while. I don't get challenged. So it doesn't take me to the portal. But again, the question is, if anything gets directed towards the portal, you're going to get challenged there.
So I think the best case scenario is to expect that you will be asked to authenticate. And really, this is for the best, because when you think about it, we always have a lot of information everywhere. Even if it doesn't seem like you do, you really do. You have your own profile in Zoom. You know, we each have our own profiles, and that's really what makes the system work. So that's why we're trying to secure all of this. So just expect that you will be asked to authenticate. It's just, you know, case by case. If you have the actual full application installed, that you might not see the screen. But if you're using your browser, most of the time you will see the authentication screen from Duo. I hope that answers the question.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Okay, we are having other questions, such as whether the email on the phones would ask to authenticate as well. The email on the phone, once you have it set up, it really just works. There's no re-authenticating each time. The other question that we have is landline. You can add landlines. Just expect that it would probably take the longest out of all the systems to log in. You would expect a phone call. Once you get the phone call, you would just follow the instructions on the screen and what they're saying in your call, and then you would log in that way. Do we have any other questions today? And please, if you'd like, you can unmute yourself or type them in the chat.
Yeah, another question. When I use my cell phone, I have to have the cell phone on to do the push, correct?
Yes.
It has to be on. It cannot just be, you know, on the sleep mode. It has to be on.
Oh, no. If you're not currently actively using your phone, if it's next to you, it's turned on. But let's say the screen is not on, but your phone is on. It's just the screen is blacked out. It's still going to buzz. It's like a text message. Well, it's not going to send you a text message unless you use the passcode. If you use the push, it works just like any other push notification from an application. It's still going to send it to you. You'll hear a buzz. And as soon as you open your phone, you can get to it from your notifications bar. And then it'll take you straight to the application where you can tap approve if it's you logging in.
As long as your phone is turned on, even if it's on.
So let me clarify this, or let me get let me ask you to clarify the question. You're talking about the phone actually turned off, completely turned off, no power, correct. Nothing?
Correct.
Then it's not going to work because your phone has to be on in order for your applications to work on your phone.
Right.
So in order for it to notify you, that phone has to be on.
Right. Even if it's all blanked out, as long as the cell phone is on, power is on, you can use it, right?
Yes. Yes. As long as your phone, the power is on your phone, you don't have to, have the application, the dual mobile application active.
Okay. Right. And how does the landline work?
So the landline, the way it works is when you set it up, you would type in your landline phone number and then it would authenticate you with a call. So after you type in your landline phone number and you click continue or next, what it's going to do is it's going to call you. So you want to keep that in mind too. So if you're like me and you ignore all unrecognized calls, well, just keep in mind, if you're going through the setup process and you typed in landline, it's going to call you. So you do want to answer that call because it's going to give you the authentication code so that you can enter it. And then it knows it's you so that it sets up that phone number. So every time you log in, you're going to get a call. So just remember that and remember to answer that call if you're going to use a call. But we don't recommend using a call because it takes the longest. And, you know, it's really easy, you know, for me to ignore that call if I'm used to not accepting calls from unrecognized phone numbers. So you might want to just keep that in mind. But
yeah, we get people that contact the help desk, or we do get alerts that says somebody's locked out because of excessive attempts. And it's only because it's trying to call and they're not answering the phone. Just be aware that the call method, we do recommend that as a secondary because we have had reported outages for phone call services or cellular services. Sometimes they do go out. And if you're relying on that phone call or you're relying on that, the cellular service, it may not be available at the time and you'll be locked out. So really the best method is to use the dual mobile app. And if you don't have cellular service to receive the challenge, what they call the challenge, through the push notification, there is an application there on there it gives you the option to do a passcode. So you can click the passcode. It'll give you a numerical value, just like a token would, and you enter those numbers into the system and it'll allow you in. But again, the dual mobile application is probably the most, it's the easiest to use and it's the most reliable.
Yeah, thank you, Cheryl.
I have a question. Okay, I'm planning to use it with the iPhone, and I understand how that works, but I'm concerned that, well, let's say my iPhone battery dies. To get a new battery might take a few days to find somebody that can do that for me, so then I'm without the service. So I know I could get a token, and I know I could also use the landline. Now, would it make sense to do this, to have all three methods in case I'm somewhere where I lose the token or that type of thing?
So that's why we're saying to have a backup. We also supports a tablet. So if you have a tablet, you can register a tablet.
I don't have one.
Yeah. So you can register multiple. You can do a cell phone. You can do a phone call. You can do a token.
Yeah. Well, I don't have a tablet, but I have an iPad Pro, you know.
That's a tablet.
That's a tablet.
Yeah. That will work.
Oh, I see. Okay. So anyway, if I choose, let's say the cell phone and the tablet, and, you know, let's say I go with those two. If one of these fails, will it go to the other one, or will it send a message to all three and let me to choose whatever one I want to respond to?
Well, what you'll see is a drop down. So all the devices that you add become a list. Right. And when you log into the portal, you can choose whichever one you want. But let's say if you set it up so that it automatically sends a push, you can set it up that way as well. But if your main device, let's say, is not working, it still gives you the option to choose another method as long as you have them set up.
Oh, yes, I understand. But if they're all set up, is it going to send a message to all three or just to like the 1, 2, 3, like the order that I choose? Like I'll like let have it sent to my iPhone first.
And if do you want to share your screen and show them where they would see that drop down?
Yeah, I'll go ahead and do that. Just give me one moment.
Or maybe we have a screen capture where you could just point to where it's at.
Oh, yeah. That'll work. So let me go back here. So right on this screen, you are going to see a drop-down list here. Now, I don't have multiple devices, which don't do that. I need to correct that as well. But once you have all your backup lists, you're always going to see this screen when you log in. And in that case, you can choose from the list that you want. Let's say your phone number ending in whatever. If it's that one by default, you can click the little dropdown and choose your iPad or choose something else. You can choose something else and then log in with it. So it lets you choose. It doesn't automatically do it.
Got it. Okay, yep. Sounds good. Well, that helps very much.
We had another question from Dr. Ulanoff, and she asked, let's see, what did she ask? Oh, she said she wanted to know if they're waiting for that 24-hour period to receive that email activation, will they be locked out? And the answer to that was, in my experience, when you enroll, it takes 24 hours for you to receive that email notification. You should not be locked out at that time. But once you receive that email notification, it will get you stuck at that register device screen. If that happens and you don't have a device, please contact the help desk.
Thank you.
Thank you. Great job.
Thank you for all the great questions. If there are any other questions, feel free to type them or unmute yourself. Otherwise, okay. That is all.
I'm sorry. Can I ask one last question?
Of course.
Sorry about that. How often do we have to log in? If I'm doing Canvas or doing a meeting over Zoom 3-4 times a day, do I have to do it 3-4 times a day?
So there is a checkbox that you can checkmark. It'll remember you for 24 hours if you want. We don't recommend using it all the time just so you can be extra secure, but that option is there for you to use.
I see. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
All right. Thank you, everyone. We are very happy that you could join us today. Remember, remind your colleagues to sign up before the deadline.
Oh, hi.
That's very important.
Yeah, one more question. I mean, I think this is a very helpful thing, but there's only about 10 people that actually participate in this, and I'm sure there's plenty other that would need to do this. Can this be saved as a link or something and maybe put on the
yes.
ITS homepage so others can look at it later?
Yes, yes. We are recording it. To all those, that clicked yes, go ahead. Thank you. And we are going to just edit it real quick and put it up for you to access. And you can share it with your colleagues.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Great. All righty. It sounds like we are all good. So thank you everyone for joining us today. We are going to call it a day so you can go ahead and finish registering your devices. Thank you very much for joining us, and last calls. of course, we have another question real quick. What about scanning the QR code? Thank you for the question. Would you like to clarify by unmuting yourself? We need a little more detail about the question. I believe the person is James. The question is the scanning the QR code part of Duo? So if you use anything like a tablet or your mobile phone, which is Android or iOS, and you want to set it up using the push notification, then yes, scanning the QR code is part of Duo, but that happens through the Duo mobile application. So just follow the on-screen instructions and you'll be able to complete the setup using that. Okay, sounds good. Thank you for the confirmation. Thank you everyone again. If you have any other questions, please, you know, feel free to reach out to us. You still have the confirmation of your registration as well from signing up for the session. So feel free to send questions there if you would like, but otherwise the contact information is on the screen, which you can reach us by. We're gonna go ahead and call it a day now. Thanks again. And hope everyone has a great day. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.